Weaving has always been the woman's domain in Morocco. Before the existence of the carpet trade, women would weave blankets and carpets for personal use. In those days, a young girl would help out around the house with all of the chores, which included cooking, cleaning, and preparing the wool for weaving. Nevertheless, it would not be until the young girl's marriage when she would weave her first rug. As a central component of the girl's dowry, that first rug would be embedded with symbols and markings that identified the girl's tribe, family, and personal story. At a certain point in Morocco, weaving transitioned from the personal to the commercial domain. With the rise of international travel and the tourist industry, carpets became an important source of income for families living in the more rural areas. In certain areas of the country, carpet weaving quickly became the constant as families scrambled to provide for themselves. The preponderance of weaving and the artisans' reliance upon carpet sales vary a great deal within Morocco based on geography. Regardless, these artisans are all trying to reach the same market. Whether the women are selling as individuals or through their own weaving organizations, they are still subject to fluctuations in the buyer's market, often determined by the middlemen. Typically, upon completion of a carpet, these weavers take their wares to the carpet section of the nearest weekly outdoor market. These women arrive at 5:30 a.m., and in the brisk morning they arrange their newly woven rugs into tented displays. Standing behind their one or two rugs, the women then wait for the middlemen to arrive, do their rounds, and name their prices. These women's sole role is thus reduced to one of either acquiescing to a price and selling a carpet, or refusing the price offered by the middlemen and watching the buyer move on to the next artisan. The middlemen have the upper hand in this case. Because most of the carpets on display are of similar designs and similar quality, the middlemen may lowball prices and be confident that at some point they'll find an artisan that needs to sell her carpet, if for nothing more than to buy medicine for her sick child, food for the family, or materials to begin weaving the next rug. Most individual weavers I have met have expressed interest in joining a cooperative or association. There are countless benefits to this type of internal organization. On the one hand, organized weavers are able to benefit from other members' strengths and expertise. On the other hand, weavers who are organized in cooperatives or associations have more opportunities to sell their wares. Due to all of their members, they usually have a large enough inventory to set up booths at festivals throughout the country. They are also more likely to be connected with foreign buyers, as they have had more time to work on product development and on their image. Nevertheless, while organized weavers avoid the pitfalls of selling only to middlemen and have greater access to different markets, they still encounter difficulties in moving their inventories. The simple fact of the matter is, there is an overabundance of the supply of carpets in Morocco. Unfortunately, the problem is not only that there is too much supply, but the quality of the products is also inconsistent. Because demand has become centralized in the hands of a few middlemen who deal uniquely with an uninformed tourist market, the types of carpets bought in the largest quantities are the ones that have the least to do with Morocco's cultural legacy of carpet weaving. Carpets are now being produced in styles that did not exist 15 years ago, but are being billed as authentic Moroccan artifacts. More than the commercialization of styles, however,